What's up, everybody? So in this video, I'm going to be giving you an update on the improvements that I'm making to the Nicaragua course. Because as I mentioned before, there's a couple things that I'm really trying to focus on doing differently now that I've made a decent amount of courses, and I feel much more comfortable in understanding what it takes to produce a profitable course. And now I understand you have to do a lot of marketing. It has to be a component of it. You have to continuously talk about your course and you have to continuously improve it, right? So one of the things that I'm seeing now is that I need to make this less vague. Like right now, it's a course, right? And I've realized as I'm describing it in my YouTube videos that like, I kind of use different words to describe it whenever I talk about what the course is. And this also isn't good. I need to have a very clear, concise definition of exactly what my course is. And I need to use that over and over and over again. I need to create a language that is the same no matter where I speak about the course, whether it's on Udemy or on YouTube or to people in real life. And this is something that is room for improvement on, right? But I want to do this video so that you guys can see, like, realistically, what kind of stuff can you work on after you've published a course? Because it can be quite intimidating sometimes when you make a course. This one, for example, right? I haven't heard anything from it. Nobody's bought it. 10 people have signed up for it, which is cool, actually, because I only gave that link to one person who I knew would do it, right? The other times, those other 9 people, they got it because they watched the middle of one of my YouTube videos where I showed it, the link on the screen, right? So that's kind of cool. It means that, okay, some of the people who were watching were interested enough to go sign up even though I didn't tell them to, which is a good sign, right? But it can be quite scary, especially if you were expecting that all you had to do was just create a course and boom, you would be selling a bunch, right? Like, I got super lucky because that was my experience with the dropshipping course. Like, I created a course and it was selling immediately as I created it, right? Obviously, that's because I was talking about YouTube. I built up all this momentum and I had very little competition because I was distributing information that most other people were charging loads and loads of money for, and they all had this big fear that someday people are going to know the secrets and they won't have anything else to charge people. I hate that mentality so much. So I was just trying to just be like, okay, anything that makes me uncomfortable because I don't know if it's good for everyone to know this info, I just got so used to just being like, make a video about it, talk about it, do it, right? Make it all accessible. And so I'm trying to take that same approach with Udemy. So you're going to be in this situation as well where you create a course and it's highly unlikely it's going to sell immediately unless you've done a lot of work to make that happen, or you're running a YouTube channel, or you're an influencer, or you're a teacher and you already have like an audience, right? The only time you'll get sales straight away is if you already have an audience. Otherwise, you should expect that in the first month or two, you may only get 1 or 2 purchases of your course. And then in the second and third month, maybe you'll get 3 or 4. That's okay. That's not the end of the world. Don't think that that means that your course is a failure, because ultimately, courses fail because they fail to be updated. And ultimately, that's why my dropshipping course is failing. Like, yeah, it's awesome. It's still earning $300 a month, but it was earning $1,600 a month, right? And I don't dropship anymore, and I also don't want to. So I don't want to do the things that are necessary to keep this as a profitable course, because I want to maintain my interest, my passion at my core. And I don't think that dropshipping is the best option for all of you. I think there are better options that fit to more kinds of people. Dropshipping works for certain kinds of people, but it's inherently quite risky, and you have to have a really risk-averse personality in order to make it work. And if you were going to do that, there's a lot of things that you can do with that personality, like dropshipping, right? But the reality is, for most people, it's not a good opportunity for them. Maybe it's something they can do in the future and do well, but when they're trying to earn money online, you're better off if you get into some form of content creation and expression where you can build traffic. Because in the online world, if you can control the traffic, even if it's just a little bit, then boom. That's something you don't have to pay for. That's like free rent. Imagine if you didn't have to pay rent in your life. That's exactly what it's like to not have to pay for traffic in the online e-commerce world when you are earning money online. to be able to bring even a little bit of traffic is huge, and you should focus on that. You are way better off learning how to create traffic and express yourself online than anything else, because that will act as a catalyst 4 years from now. If you continuously express yourself on the internet and open yourself up that way, and you network and you meet people through that, you will be in a much better position than if you just try and pursue something that's going to earn you money right now. If you want to earn money online, the best way to do it is to try and pursue as many things that earn you money a year from now or 2 years from now. And do you know why? Because most people are way too impatient to bother doing that. So you guarantee that you will have way less competition than almost anything else. And what most online work boils down to, unfortunately, is not quality. I would like to say that earning money online is about putting out quality. And it is to a point. But what's actually more important is the amount of competition that you have. Because even if you have a low quality product, but it satisfies, it meets a demand, and there's no competition, even though your product is low quality, you can earn a really high amount of money from that. Whereas you could be in a very competitive field and really pour your heart into something and put out a lot of it, but then there's a million other courses. There's a million other products very similar to that. You know? You have a lot of competition. So just because you work hard doesn't mean that you're going to get results. And the thing that's most important is having as little competition as possible. That's really what makes your chance of success higher. If you have 3 or 4 competitors, wow, that's good. Like if there is literally 3 or 4 people on this earth competing with you, you are doing dang well. That's amazing. Because most of the time, we're talking about hundreds of thousands or millions of competitors. There are billions of people on this earth. So even if 1% of 1% of those people are competing with you, that is an inordinately big number. The chance of you doing well is way less likely. So if you can have all this foresight to think about this years ago, imagine if 4 years ago you had started creating content, you had started learning how to bring traffic to people online, what would you be able to do now? Where would you be now? We often pursue this relentless desire to earn money right now, and by doing that, we guarantee that we are always competing with as many people as possible, because most people are impatient, they can't deal with instability, and they want to know what they're getting right now. And this is so evident how ingrained into our culture this is and how much of an obstacle it ends up playing in the road to full self-employment. Because when people start doing self-employment work, you can tell by the questions they ask that they are still stuck in this mentality of wanting results right now and not thinking about the future. They think about the future, but in a paranoid, numerical, money-earning way, not in a how can I put myself to be in the position where I have the least amount of competition and the maximum chance of success, right? Isn't that what you want, really? That's what everyone wants. But we all have these mentalities that stop us from doing that. We take the impatient, close, quick routes for things instead of doing the more patient, long, maybe a little bit tedious, better option. And I'm going to tell you one question that helps to identify this mentality. It's, how much do you earn per month? If you find yourself asking this, you are still in the mentality of earning money now. You have to gain so much information, so much understanding that you know exactly what will happen when something is done over a long period of time. And you have confidence that you will do it. You may earn nothing your first month. That doesn't mean you're never gonna earn any money. It's completely possible to earn nothing for 2 or 3 years and then get to a point where you stumble on hundreds of thousands of dollars. That's not typical, but it happens. What's more typical is to earn nothing for a year or two and then start earning like $500-$600 a month, right? But there I am. Did you catch that? I just catered towards that mentality, when the reality is, you can never know what you're getting per month. You can only see what you've done up until this point. You can assume, wrongly, incorrectly, that it's going to continue just the way it's been. But that's not how this world works. Everything in the self-employment world has a death. It has an end date. Every income stream you develop has a life cycle. And you can put more work into these income streams to extend their life cycles further. But you can never prevent the fact that they will eventually die. Something else will happen beyond your control. Or this industry, the circumstances that created the opportunity will change. So, one of the big problems that I see with the course so far is that it is too vague. So I'm going to change the title. And I was really inspired, actually, by a webinar that I participated in yesterday. And I was just a guest on somebody's webinar. And this person told me that there are 4 million people retiring every year in the U.S. for the next like 6 or 7 years. There's a big spike in retirees because the baby boomers are retiring now, right? And I was thinking about that, and I was like, okay. When I was making this course, I felt confident that I knew exactly who I was marketing the course to. And it's people who earn money online or are retiring and would benefit from changing their location. But honestly, I was saying that, but in my head, a lot of it was people like me. But I have to understand that there are very specific, unusual circumstances that led to me moving to Nicaragua. It wasn't a decision that I made. It was a series of events in my life that made that happen. And I think I need to be more careful, because I shouldn't assume that tons of people are willing to just move to a foreign country that there's a ton of stigma about, right? That doesn't make sense. That's not how it works. But what about people who are already looking for somewhere else? What about people who statistically, there's loads of retirees? So now I'm seeing that, okay, I'm a 26-year-old, right? I am not retiring in any way. But if I think about it, like, realistically, I quit my job and moved to Nicaragua, and from that point forward, only worked 1 to 2 hours per day, aside from certain stretches where I became quite interested in something and worked for, like, 6 or 7 hours. But that's unusual. And, like, I'm 26, but, I mean, that's retiring, isn't it? Like, isn't that what retired people do? They quit their job, and then maybe they'll pick up a hobby for an hour or two a day. But that change that I did by coming here is literally exactly what these retirees are looking to do. So maybe this is my window. Maybe I was thinking that I need to think about people like me, but maybe that's wrong. Maybe I need to think about the group, the demographic that is most likely to engage in the content, which probably isn't people like me, because most Americans my age haven't traveled so much. They're not so comfortable just changing their location. They have a lot of preconceptions. I battled with these preconceptions, but I didn't even live in America till I was like 10. You know, I traveled in a whole bunch of different countries, yet that didn't prevent me from having these preconceptions about Nicaragua. So by choosing to try and market this towards people who are in my demographic, I think that I would actually be hurting the performance of the course. It may make a lot more sense to market it towards retirees, because these people are already looking to leave the country, or they're at least humoring the idea of moving. And a lot of people don't have enough money to retire. The fear of not being able to retire in American society is real. That is an authentic, actual feeling that huge quantities of people have. So perhaps the best thing for me to do is move forward with this course thinking about retirees, because it's not only these feelings that are leading me to think this, it's also a marketing strategy. So just so you guys know, like, I've published this course, but I haven't created a promotional video yet. I also haven't set up an advertising campaign for the course. And the reason I haven't done that yet is because I wanted to make the course first so that I know what it is and I have something, and then take a break, go somewhere else, and then come back to it and then develop the marketing strategy. I felt that if I tried to develop the marketing strategy immediately after making the course, that I wouldn't be in the best place or state of mind to come up with an effective marketing strategy. And I also didn't feel completely confident how I would market the course, because this course, I'm not very confident, or at least I wasn't before, about how to market it. And that's also a reason I didn't do the promotional video and the marketing until this point. But with the Spanish content course, which is a separate project, that I know exactly how I'm going to market. I really feel confident about the marketing process for that content. It's much more of a full picture in that sense, because in this, I knew that people have told me about this problem. I knew I could create solutions to these problems, but I wasn't sure how I was going to inform and keep people updated that my solution to this problem exists, right? But I think I've stuck onto it by focusing on retirees, because this is a specific demographic that I can target on YouTube. I can expose my content to, and I can literally say, have you thought about retiring in Nicaragua? I live here. This is what it's like. I can play off of the contradictions that I love, because I'm a young person talking about it, right? And they're going to judge that. They're going to think, why is this young person telling me about retirement? But it's literally exactly what I've done, and they can do it easier if they have a pension. There's literally a law that allows them to live here without dealing with any of the visa stuff that I have to do. So it's actually easier, and they can also claim a dependent. So for $100 extra of proved income, they can bring another person into the country as a resident. Like, wow, I can't do that. That's way more useful, right? So there's a lot of things that are good for retirees in that sense. And also the weather, there's no winter. That's a retirement thing. And like I said earlier, there's all these fears about not being able to retire. But in Nicaragua, you could retire if you only have like $100,000 saved up. And maybe $100,000 sounds like a lot of money to you, but like for retirement metrics, that's not enough to exist in the United States. If you have $100,000 to retire on, you are going to run out of money before you die. Absolutely. That's realistic. Way before you die, right? But in Nicaragua, it's a bit different. It's realistic for you to spend $500 a month here. I know my role is to connect these groups of people. I'm just not sure exactly how I'm going to do that. But I know that the first thing is to change the title of my course from How to Reduce Cost of Living by Moving to Nicaragua to something focusing on retirees. And also, the next step is to create that promotional video so that I have an ad that Udemy can use for my course and I can target ads with on YouTube. But first, let's take care of that. So if you want to edit your title in a Udemy course, you go to your main course page, click on Edit Manage Course. Now move down to Course Landing Page. From here, this is the course title. It's funny because the course title is like the first thing, but it's actually the third section that you create. And we're going to say How to Retire or Move to Managua or Nicaragua. I'm debating whether it should be How to Retire or Move to Nicaragua in Latin America. I think so. Because the reality is there's way, 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 way more people in the US who are already looking at retiring in Costa Rica or Mexico or some Latin American place. These are the people who are like most likely to be able to be convinced that Nicaragua is a good option, right? And I don't need to convince people to actually move here. I just need to get people to be interested enough that they want to learn more about it and they view me as a way to do that. That's my goal. That's all I want to do, right? If they then actually move forward with it and end up coming here and I meet them, that is super cool. But that's not like what I'm focused on, you know? I'm just focused on trying to connect the people, create this product, keep working on it, keep making it better. That's the goal, right? So now we have a focus, and this is great because I wasn't sure about this before. And if you want success in courses, you need to have course creation. That course needs to be able to be created. You must be confident that you will actually go through and create an entire course, right? You can't just think about doing it. You have to actually do it. So that's a part. You need the course. And then you need a marketing strategy. And then you also need to consistently talk about your course. And this is kind of hand in hand with marketing, but okay, for example, imagine that I'm just making my YouTube videos. And I'm talking to you guys about the course, but I don't have I'm not paying for advertisements in any way. That in my head isn't a full business model for the course. You need that other part where you have identified a specific group of people that you perceive your course provides a solution to, and you are paying to get direct access to those people. And you also need to still do the part where you're talking regularly about it. Because people need to know that you have courses. People need to occasionally bring up to your friends, oh yeah, he makes courses for a living or whatever. Like, that is important as well. And you can't just do the marketing. That's not as effective. It's not having the full circle. You need the marketing. You need to talk about your courses regularly. And you need the course. That's the full circle. And until this point, I felt like this course didn't have all those components. I could talk about it, and I was getting better about the lingo, trying to determine a rhetoric that I should use. And by the way, in your courses as well, you should sound very confident when you are talking about what the course does. And you should be able to explain it in 1 to 2 sentences. And it should be those same sentences every time you explain it. People should get tired of hearing you say that same sentence, but they should know exactly what it is. The mistake that I'm making right now is that I talk about the course, but in a very roundabout way. I talk about it, but I use different words to talk about it, and I talk about it a little bit too long when I do talk about it, right? And I'm aware of that, and I'm working on it, so I gotta figure out like 2 sentences. And I didn't know how to do that before. It felt too general, too vague, right? But now I have something specific that I know has a huge demographic of people that it could be relevant to that I can develop a specific marketing campaign for. So that's awesome. All right, guys. That's everything for this video. All I actually did is change the title of this course. But I really want to hammer this mentality down with you guys. I understand that in the beginning of the video, it may have felt that I like ranted and went on too much of a tangent, but there's a lot of kind of abstract things that you have to become confident with and you have to understand very well if you want success in anything that you do. If you want to learn to create courses, you can't just learn about creating courses because just because you have the information doesn't mean you're going to do it. You need to become a person who does the things that you want to do. Chances are you aren't that person. And if you are, you only are sometimes. But you can be that person most of the time, right? And I know that it seems tangential and it maybe seems like ranting to you, but these things all have a purpose and they're all relevant to anybody who is seriously considering and interested in earning money online without having to rely on other people always telling them exactly what to do. Okay? So, with that, this video is over. If you're interested in booking any time with me, I do consultations. We can talk about anything you want. You can also use me as motivation or encouragement. All you do is go to calendly.com, calendly.com/JackDermottPitman. And from here, you'll be able to book a private call for 30 minutes for $20 or a public call. The public call is recorded and published to my YouTube channel. The private call is just me and you. and you tell me whatever it is you want to talk about. You can grill me on a specific subject, or you can use me as a brainstorming session for a specific problem that you have, okay? You can also use me to hold you accountable. You can tell me, hey, Jack, when you call me, ask me about the past week and ask me if I did this. And then I will call you and ask you exactly what you told me to. I will help you bridge the gap between the person you are now and the person that you want to be. All right, guys. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Ciao.